Welcome to Crypto Jargon. In this episode, Stablecoin, Virgin Coin, Privacy Coin, Shitcoin, Scam Coin, Equity Token, Utility Token, and Security Token explained. In a previous episode of Crypto Jargon, we explained the difference between a coin and a token. So now let's break down the types of coins and tokens that are currently most commonly used in crypto. Starting with Stablecoin, which was born in opposition to the very volatile nature of cryptocurrencies in general. As you know, prices of most cryptocurrencies fluctuate in extremes, sometimes by more than 100% in a day or even in hours. So the necessity for traders to have alternatives gave birth to these so-called stablecoins. Typically, a stablecoin is an asset, not a currency, which offers price stability characteristics. It is mainly designed to be used as a unit of account or a store of value. Most stablecoins today are cryptocurrencies that are pegged to another stable asset like silver, gold, or a fiat currency such as the US dollar. Some prominent examples of stablecoins are USD Tether, True USD, and USD Coin. Many exchanges that do not operate directly with fiat money are using stablecoins as alternatives to the fiat money these coins are pegged to. Stable is used in this case as a broad term, of course, as the US dollar itself is not 100% stable, but as a world reserve currency, it is accepted as the standard for determining the Bitcoin value worldwide. So most stablecoins are fixed to be at 1-to-1 ratio with the US dollar for that purpose. Virgin Coin is simply a brand new coin acquired through mining that has not yet been used in any transactions or being spent yet. Okay, the next one is Privacy Coin. As the name suggests, this is a type of cryptocurrency that has privacy features such as enhanced level of anonymity or masking layers that obfuscate the addresses of its senders or receivers or both. Since Bitcoin is not fully anonymous, but all its transactions are traceable and publicly visible, some altcoins are focusing on providing anonymous features in order to compete with Bitcoin. Such coins are Monero, Zcash, Dash, Zen, and many others. Now, when we mention scam coin and a shitcoin, it becomes clear that we're talking about something that is not very legit or at least not very valuable. Shitcoin, pardon my French, is a term typically given to those alts that have no use or potential value. Could be any new altcoin that is not mainstream or does not add innovation to the market. In trading world, however, this is not necessarily a bad term. Some traders don't avoid a coin because it has weak fundamentals. They care mostly about technical analysis and they would often trade this for short-term gains. However, if you see yourself as an investor rather than a speculator, you should not really touch this simply because they don't have a future in the long term. A scam coin, on the other hand, is a term referring to a cryptocurrency that is dubious in nature and doesn't have any specific tech behind it. Its sole purpose is to make the creators of it rich and usually becomes a subject to pump and dump practices and market manipulation until it loses all its value. BitConnect and OneCoin are two such examples of scam coins. No real tech in them, no use case, and with heavy MLM compensation plans to attract new investors. Stay away from any MLM crypto is my advice. I've never seen a decent cryptocurrency come out of this network marketing model, ever. Now moving on to tokens. As I explained, tokens are different to coins due to the fact that they are created as smart contracts on an existing blockchain such as Ethereum or EOS, Stellar, NEO, and many others. Tokens have various functions. They can be protocol tokens, those that act as a platform on which to build decentralized applications, dApps, such as Gnosis, Stellar, and other types of tokens could be utility tokens. A utility token is a unit of currency consumed in a process, providing access or a service or access to the product. For example, an arcade token that gets used when a video game is played, or a coin like BNB, Binance Coin, which is used to pay exchange fees, hence the word utility, because it has use. A security token is a token on the blockchain that represents a real asset. An example of a security token would be shares in a company issued on the blockchain, or a token is considered a security if it fulfills the following criteria. It is an investment of money. The investment is in a common enterprise. There is an expectation of profit from the work of promoters of the third party. Because these tokens are deemed a security, they are subject to government regulations. Examples of security tokens are Tezos and Polymath, for instance. Then we have commodity tokens. These are tokens backed by real-world commodities, whether it is gold or silver or oil. The rate of these tokens depends on the rate of the commodity backing it. For instance, Digix and El Petro are two such examples. Lastly, there's even collectible tokens. CryptoKitties and Rare Pepe are such examples. These tokens represent a virtual collectible unit like baseball cards, adorable kitties or memes, and they're built on the blockchain. And this concludes today's episode of Crypto Jargon. If you like this episode, give me the thumbs up and also leave a comment. Don't forget to share it with someone else who might also benefit from watching this episode. And if you are new to this channel, feel free to subscribe and click the notification icon so that you never miss an episode. Thanks for watching. I'm gonna see you in the next one. Enjoying this content? Go check out Crypto Jargon, the ebook, out now on Kindle. It's an Amazon bestseller and it's the most up-to-date crypto dictionary with more than 700 terms, acronyms and trading slang related to cryptocurrencies and blockchain tech. Just go to ojjordan.com/cryptojargon and grab your digital copy today.